Philippine Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno says only 11% of the proposed 5.3 trillion peso national budget for next year has been set aside for debt payment. He says 611 billion pesos is allocated for debt burden, which includes 582 billion pesos for interest payments. Diokno is clarifying reports saying debt payments would eat up one-third or about 1.6 trillion pesos of the budget for next year. The country's sovereign debt stood at 12.79 trillion pesos as of end June. But Diokno has repeatedly said it remains manageable and the economy would outgrow it. The House of Representatives will begin deliberations on the 2023 spending bill Friday.
Two retired Philippine Chief Justices become legal advisors to the Energy Department. Energy Secretary Rafael Lobilla announced retired Chief Justices Renato Puno and Artemio Pangaliban will help the agency with multiple legal challenges in the energy sector. These include issues such as foreign ownership of renewable energy and cross-border contracts for exploration.
When we, for example, talk about renewable energy and attracting foreign investments for, let us say, offshore wind that require a lot of foreign capital, we would have to deal with issues like, are foreigners allowed to invest more than 40% in, let us say, offshore wind? We know that we need to have further development of our gas and oil resources. And in order to attract sufficient investment for that, we need to be able to clearly indicate what are the policies of government on this.
The Justice Department, for its part, has formed its own legal cluster that will address issues and cases linked to the energy sector. The cluster is composed of the legal group of the Power Sector Assets and Liabilities Management Corporation, or PSOC, the Energy Division of the Office of the Government Corporate Counsel, and the Office of the Secretary of Justice.
Despite an increase in prices, the Philippine Trade Department assures the public the country has enough supply of salt. More from Jervis Manahan.
The suggested retail price of salt has slightly gone up, based on the August 12 bulletin of the Department of Trade and Industry. But the agency clarifies, this is not due to supply shortage. Undersecretary Ruth Castelo said the price increase is long overdue, as traders have not increased prices in more than 5 years.
Meron talaga tayong mga inalaw na pagtaas ng presyo ng asin. Kaya lang, kailangan rin maintindihan natin, Aljo, that itong mga manufacturers nito sobrang tagal na hindi nagtataas ng presyo. Parang umabot na ng 4, 5, 6 years bago sila nag-request ulit.
Castelo said there's no reason for the public to worry since there is enough supply in the market.
Ang pagtaas ng presyo ng mga ilan na locally manufactured ay dahilan lang po sa kailangan na talaga nilang magtaas over the years. Ngayon lang po ulit sila nagtataas. Hindi po dahil sa shortage natin ng asin. So hindi po tayo makukulangan ng supply.
In Muñoz Market in Quezon City, vendors have felt the price hike. A sack of salt now costs 330 pesos compared to just over 200 pesos in the past years.
Hindi naman po agad-agad mataas. Konti-konti lang naman ang taas nila. Kasi araw-araw kailangan ginagamit. Sanay na rin kasi talagang ganun eh. Kailangan kasi pang gamit natin araw-araw naman yun.
Department of Agriculture Senior Undersecretary Domingo Panganiban earlier said he will focus on increasing local salt production as the market is still dominated by imported salt.
Mag-aasa na nasa Batangas. Nasa Cagayan Valley,
apa?
Nasa Mindanao, maliliit eh. Production efforts na dapat i-accelerate para ma-meet yung standards ng ibang activity na dapat mangyari because we need to feed them in salt. Kaya program as asin, we are importing asin eh.
As a possible solution, Cabayan Party List Representative Gonzalo filed House Bill 1976, which aims to develop the salt industry in the country. The measure calls for the creation of a new government agency, even as the Marcos administration looks to trim the bureaucracy. The proposed new agency will reportedly focus on the revitalization of the salt industry through incentives to farmers and exporters. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
A look now at the financial markets. Wall Street rallied Thursday, lifted by gains in Nvidia and other tech stocks as investors await Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell's speech in Jackson Hole. The tech-heavy Nasdaq outperformed, climbing 1.7%. The S&P 500 gained 1.4%, while the Dow added 300 points. Over in Europe, markets were mostly higher, with all eyes also on the Jackson Hole conference as investors watch out for clues on the Fed's policy outlook. And here in Asia, shares also advanced ahead of Powell's speech in Wyoming. Hong Kong's Hang Seng Index led gains. Philippine shares also jumped nearly 1%, back above the 700 level.